better than that.
About a year or two ago, this lovely young girl got a cat. Today, she will be telling us about her emotional journey with her cat. So, Tabby, I understand that you have a cat. How old is he?
I'm so sorry we can't make your barbecue. I'm just sick of it.
Yes, he's about 2 or 3 years old.
What is the cat's name?
And they pay you cash and just
his name is Oreo.
See how Aflac helps cover everyday expenses at Aflac.
Can I ask why you named him Oreo?
Family story.
Ancestry DNA. I named him Oreo because he has the colors and similarities of an Oreo cookie. That's just my imagination, really.
How did you find out that you were getting Oreo?
My little sister spoiled the surprise because she's not very good at keeping secrets. So, yeah.
Why do you think that you got your cat? Like, what is the reason that your mom got you a cat?
About a month earlier, we had just lost a kitten. We named her Lucky because we'd just gotten her at the beginning of summer. Our neighbor brought her over, and she said that this lady couldn't take care of her anymore, and she had something too much going on and stuff like that, so she couldn't take care of her anymore, and my neighbor brought her over because she knew about that, and she had to be put down because she had distemper. So when I found out they had put her down, I was really sad and depressed. I kept telling my mom that I wanted a black and white cat just like her for Christmas, because she was my everything.
Can you tell us about your cat?
Yes, my fuzzy feline and his brothers and sisters were brought to a veterinary clinic because there was a lady who couldn't take care of them. And my mom's dog, Baby, I think she was 2 at the time, she had to go to the vet for some reason. I don't really remember why she had to go to the vet. And the vet we went to knew that my mom loves to rescue animals. So basically, they said that if my mom would take the whole litter home with her, obviously not that day because they weren't that old. But when they were finally old enough, I remember it was a Monday, they weren't supposed to come to our house until Tuesday. There was supposed to be a surprise for me when I saw I saw 5 kittens when I looked over, and of course the mama wasn't going to be there, so because it had been run over, and it was a Monday, and they weren't supposed to come to the house until the next day, which was Tuesday, and they came a day early, which was really surprising for me. So, when I saw my cat was the one, when I saw them, like, I knew my cat was the one because he stood out to me the most, and at first I thought he was a girl, but guess I was wrong. You know, I mean, I really feel bad for black and white cats and black cats in general because the sun would be attracted to their fur and they could die from overheating or just the heat in general. black and white cats could die out there, you know. If the lady wouldn't have brought those kittens into the vet, they would have been ran over too, because one, they were kittens, two, their mother was run over by a car. And unfortunately, it took him a really long time to grow because he was the runt of the whole litter of kittens, and I considered him the sick kitten because, I mean, he didn't act like a kitten. He was more a cuddly type kitten. So, yeah.
Can you tell us how you got your cat?
Yes.
Has your cat ever gotten out of the house and just ran away?
I'd come home one day from my dad's, and I did what I normally did. You know, I go look for my cat, and I couldn't find him anywhere. He was nowhere to be found in the house. And Mom had told me that my gotten out of the house, and we couldn't find him. My stepfather knew where he was, but I mean, I kind of knew, but at the same time, I didn't.
Can you tell me the story about how that all went down?
So about a year after I got him, he had run away. I cried myself to sleep every night because, to me, I was basically his mother. That's just how I interpreted it. Because I had raised him, and you know, nobody really believes me when I say that I am practically his mother. When he came back, about a month, 2 weeks to a month later, about pretty much a month, when he finally came home, he didn't just walk through the door because, I mean, obviously that's impossible. He started to cry, like, he would meow really loud to the point where my stepdad could hear him outside the house. And, at first, when he told me that he heard a cat, I thought to myself, is he really back? Like, because I could hear just a little bit of it, too. Because he'd called my name, and I was like, yeah, okay. I told him, could this really be him, you know? It's like this thing called mother's instincts or intuition or something like that. That is exactly what it alarmed inside of me because, you know, I had heard him, and I recognize his meow, because he used to come to me for everything. Like, I mean everything. Like, he wanted food, no problem, I'll give you food, you know? But he just sounds like a girl for some reason. When we'd walked outside, he instantly ran into the backyard. I think he was just scared, but you know, I stopped for a second and listened because I knew he wouldn't stop until, you know, he knew it was us. And I could still hear him, you know, meowing and crying for me or something. I don't know. So I ran toward, I heard the noise, and he was peeking out from underneath the car. My stepdad's car that had been at his friend's and stuff. I asked Mom, could this really be my cat? Could this really be Oreo?
Can you tell us when this happened and how you felt?
We are doing just wonderful. He has his days where he doesn't even want to come to me and ask for attention, and other days he'll just come up to me and ask for attention. It all depends on, you know, his mood during the day. So, yeah.
Wow. And how are you and your cat, Oreo, doing today?
Yes, I work at Lakeside Lutheran Home, and I'm a dietary aide there.
Now that your cat is back and with you, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, the look on his face would be like, Mom, where were you? Or, hey, Mom, where the heck did you come from? You weren't here earlier. You know, I mean, it's, I don't know. He just gives me weird looks sometimes. It's kind of funny.
What do you and your cat love to do together?
Oh, that's a tough question. My cat and I would most likely go find a place to live or just somewhere that I can have him in the house.
Don't worry. I'll meet you there. I promise. And don't forget, you're my number one customer.
And I would find other cats that would need to be saved and take them in and care for them as much as they need, even if it was an old cat or a kitten. You know, I'd take it to the vet. You know, I'd do all the steps that I need to do when doing that. So, yeah.
Do you have a job?
Yes.
When you come home, does Oreo run up to you? What is your favorite type of dog and or cat?
A pixel mine.
I'm videotaping.
And 1, 2, 3, go.
I'm already starting.
Hey you. Yeah you. I'm talking to you. Hey you.
No,
they
have
the kids.
No, that ain't what it says.
I don't know what that says.
Send out your freaking words!
I can't! I don't!
What is it?
What? The wheels on the bus go round and round.
Round and round. Round and round, the wheels on the bus go round and round, all through the town.
The wheels on the car go round and round.
The wheels on the van go round and round. The semi goes round and round on the...
truck. No.
Wow.
That ain't what it says.
What? I don't take them back yet.
Well, that way they don't get lost. What? Each of us has a favorite season. Dad likes winter. He likes the falling snow. Mom likes spring. She likes the flowers that grow. My sister likes summer. She likes to swim.
Don't press it!
I'm not. Get your finger away from it then. Really? That hurts. Aww, I love you too. Oh! What? You little shit. Can I take it now? I got ya.
Is that coming here, Lydia?
So, ready?
Did you? You stopped it, didn't you?
No.
Let me see it. Hey, keep it going. Hey. Be nice.
Say be nice if you did it. Okay?
It won't get my sound anyways, Lid. Keep there. Don't move it.
Yeah. I wish I took a picture. Wow.
You still got it recording?
Yeah.
Don't restart it.
What? What do you?
Lydia, you need to stand up.
Now?
No, don't stop it.
I did not. What? What?
Wait, didn't I just have this one? No, I didn't. Get a picture. Or no, don't take the picture. Just don't play this mess with it.
I can see what you're doing.
Lydia, you need to watch the camera and not the cat. Make sure it's facing towards us.
It is.
Remember.
Ow! Cat.
Keep it rolling.
What's it talking to you?
Okay, there should be 1, 2, 3, 4. Where's number 5?
What the hell? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Should be 5.
What? 5 might be out there. Wait, you want to do it with me? What?
No, don't do it again, because it's not going to get in. Remember it. Oh. Hey, Brett. Lydia, you're not going to be able to get it, so just give up.
What?
Okay, here, you go out there with the camera and go in the same spot that you were in.
Oh, just say hey.
Remember, you got it rolling?
Is it?
Just keep it rolling.
Hi, Bella.
Hi, Brett. Bye-bye. Okay, I'm gonna go put you back.
That's the bad pool. Lydia, get off of it! She wants to go in there! Lid! Let her go in the kennel if she wants to!
Tammy, can I take this off?
Go upstairs and take it off and put on your old shirt.
No! It's okay. You're okay.
Elsa!
And? Ready, Lydia?
Yeah.